I loved the film. I am a huge fan of jazz and blues and every variation thereof. So I was excited to hear all about, and I'm saddened to say I never heard about Ellis Marsalis. How I missed that part of history, I don't know, but I'm really glad that you have educated me about what an important man he was in the life of history and jazz as well as civil rights.
Well, thanks for saying that, and I'm glad that you appreciated the film. Yeah, I mean he was an enormously important person, and not in New Orleans he was very known. Perfect.
Right. When you met Alice, what was the spark that you said, I have to tell his story?
Well, first of all, his amazing playing, right? I mean,
Oh,
it was.
yeah.
It's really astounding, right? And every time, I mean, I've been sitting with this material, with the footage for so long, and every time, and even through all of the edits, I always think of, wow, how amazing his he what a great artist. So that, and then I also felt his personality was very intriguing to me because he was just so modest and had a great sense of humor, very subtle, which I liked. And he I always had the feeling he's just himself. He's not putting up any kind of show. He's just who he is. He's pursuing his life the way he decided to pursue it. He's stuck by his own values. And I felt from the beginning, I thought amazing that he would have lived through all these ups and downs and upheavals, accomplished so much. And against all these obstacles, and raised so many beautiful people, and his sons, talented sons, and also in a sense raised the students he was teaching. And I don't know if you noticed, remember in the film he says he never even wanted to become a teacher, which was so adorable to me because.
And yes, and in one of the interviews, one of his students said that he gave him, I'm going to get choked up thinking about this, he gave him a key to the back door to his office so that he wouldn't have an excuse to not be able to practice. And that changed the course of his life. It was like they hit a crossroads, and Ellis allowed him to go in a different direction.
And it was, I think, this believing in people and seeing something in them that made him stand. I mean, that was probably the first thing that made him stand out as a teacher. And I also really, Jesse McBride said that, and I always choke up when I think about this because you can see it made such a difference in his life.
And you acquire so much great footage from back in that time period, as well as all those photographs that just make it really come to life. Tell me about integrating all of that and acquiring all the footage and the stills.
Oh, so this is such an interesting question. I'm very much into history, so I'm really a history buff, and I think performances are just a great avenue to think about history, actually. I was very lucky that I worked with Bonnie Rowan in DC. She's sort of the go-to person for the National Archives. And so the National Archives, a lot of the, I would say the majority of the black and white footage is from the National Archives. And that was a real treasure trove. And that's where the historical context grew from that. That was really wonderful. And then there are archives in New Orleans that I accessed. There's the Hogan Jazz Archive. They've been extremely supportive and giving photos, and the Jazz Museum. But then I also sat with Ellis and we looked through his photo album and he told me stories about each photo, and then we scanned it together, and that's the other huge source. And that was just very very beautiful afternoon, I have to say, we spent together there.
You have Wendell Pierce, I believe his name is, favorite actor of mine. And his interview, his words really struck home with me. He said that people in that generation needed to find their creative freedom before their physical freedom. And then it was that intersection about how music taps into humanity and the universality of it all. That really struck a chord with me. And I think Seeing the transformation of music from that time period and the race issues, I hadn't really thought of it in that way. Is there anything in the film that really struck a chord with you that maybe changed your perspective about how you see music and how it's transformed?
I can't say that it is one thing, but I feel that Wendell really expressed the overall thought or the thoughts I have on this, that this music and sticking to this music and pursuing this music in the way Ellis wanted to, right, was really a form of self-determination, and it was, of course, an artistic expression, but an expression of personality, of culture, and of believing in oneself. And he passed on this belief to so many other people. But I actually really think that Wendell puts it best, that it was that you need that creative freedom to feel who you are. And maybe everything else came out of that. I don't want to make it too big, but I think it contributed enormously to all the struggles for equality.
Right. And I want to circle back a little bit to the historical aspect of all of this. Is there, I learned a lot from your film. I had never seen footage of Bloody Sunday, which I can't believe I had never seen that before. Is there anything that you learned that surprised you about American history or about history in general that you didn't know?
The extent of how segregation really affected the day-to-day. Because, I mean, obviously, I'm a white woman, I'm German, we have a lot of baggage history, Germany, obviously, so I'm very prepared for the ugliness in the world. But I'm white and I haven't lived through segregation, so to see this, I mean, this amazing man, this great artist, and to think that he had to cope with those kind of limitations and that that was the norm for so many. I knew that, but I didn't really know it. And I feel you only know that if you get close to someone and or hear their stories and see also what they choose to talk about. And he talked about this quite a bit, and he talked about it in a very matter of fact way. That's the way it was, and that struck a real chord with me.
Oh God. Do you feel, and I just have one last question for you. Do you feel in retrospect that maybe jazz in general, or maybe even Ellis himself has influenced your style of filmmaking in any way?
Oh yeah, absolutely. I always feel so big to say make those statements about myself, but I do feel that that the music itself, there is a certain freedom and the flow to it. That's always really important for me, to that there's some sort of harmony or flow to it. And I can't say that I'm emulating him, it's just too big, you know. You know, that's just the fact, the truth. The complexity is enormous, but of his work. But I mean, the complexity of jazz and the way has so many different components, and the way the musicians interact with each other, that certainly has influenced my thinking all through my life. And I also, so to me, it was also Ellis is the main voice, and then the others come sort of also speak to him and respond to him. And that's, maybe if you want to really stretch it, that's a bit of a jazz thing.
Very good. Sasha Just, thank you so much for talking with me about Ellis Marsalis. And that smile on his face will stay with me forever.
Oh, that's so sweet. Thank you so much.